Justin Saffron from the Monticello, the assistant curator, kick off the brief introduction, because I know you guys are not here to hear us talk, but we've got a few words to say, so without further ado, Justin.
I have to set the historical context here. It's Monticello, it's what we do. this project, Mark and I have been talking about, working on literally for years, probably 8 years at least, ever since the opening of Jefferson's restored beer cellar up under the house on the mountaintop. I think Mark kind of saw that story, heard the story of Jefferson and brewing, Jefferson's enslaved Peter Hemmings and his brewing operation here on the mountaintop. It was sort of all of this research that came out of the restoration of the beer cellar, sort of where this project began. Very quickly, the story is, in the fall of 1813, an Englishman named Joseph Miller was kind of waylaid here at Monticello. It was War of 1812 was going on, and he had been a brewer in England. Jefferson convinced him to stick around and teach Peter Hemmings how to brew on a larger kind of plantation industrial scale. So it's in the 18 teens and later that Peter Hemmings was brewing about 100 gallons of ale every spring and fall. As far as what was that beer like, we sort of talk a little bit about the recipe for our current beer, and it's inspired by what was being brewed here. In that Jefferson was very particularly using the grains grown here on the plantation, kind of in this self-plantation self-sufficiency model, using ingredients grown here in order to brew beer. And beer was the sort of regular standard table drink. If wine was sort of after the meal, a little more special, beer and cider what was being consumed regularly. So back to the recipe. Essentially, we think of ales, we think of beer as being malted barley based. Jefferson was using a lot of wheat and a lot of corn, and some hops as well. And so it's coming out of the documentary record, Jefferson's growing patterns. We know what was being grown here. Also correspondence between Jefferson and some of his friends and neighbors, like Madison, writing back and forth about his successful brewing operation here at Monticello. So this is where we sort of draw inspiration for the recipe. Mark, would you like to speak a bit about the beer itself?
Absolutely. So my name is Mark Thompson. I'm the founder and the owner of Starr Hill Brewing Company out in Crozet, Virginia. We started off downtown in the Starr Hill neighborhood of Charlottesville. My story is I was born and raised here in Charlottesville, Virginia, went to Western Albemarle High School, James Madison University, where I got my Bachelor's of Science degree. But I probably came, and since my mother, of course, I had to bring her off. I probably came to Monticello at age 3, age 4, and have been up here many, 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 many times throughout my life, and have heard what I thought every story there possibly could be about the history and about Monticello and about Jefferson. You know, graduated from James Madison University, got a Bachelor's of Science degree, moved to Portland, Oregon in the early 90s when they first started making craft brewed beers, microbrew beers. Came back in September of 1999 to found Starr Hill Brewing Company. And about that same time, as Justin said, they were restoring Thomas Jefferson's beer cellar. And with that came some stories about, as Justin had mentioned, how Jefferson was everything local and tried his hand at everything. But I had never, ever, and I couldn't believe, heard the story of Jefferson's beer and how he made beer and built a brew house up in Monticello. And so I got very, very excited, and I think I called Justin to the Monticello and said, we need to make a historically accurate beer because I'm the beer guy, and that's what I do. We went back and forth and back and forth for about eight years, but this has been a labor of love, and as I told Justin on the walk in here, I rarely get nervous anymore talking in front of people or doing the beer guy thing, but this is a huge deal for me, a huge deal for Starr Hill. I hope it's a big thing for Albemarle County, for the city of Charlottesville, to kind of get the story of Jefferson's beer out. As I jokingly say, Jefferson tried to make wine and failed, but we all know his wine story. So we're very excited to bring the beer story back to life. And I'd like to introduce Levi Duncan, who's my lead brewer at Starr Hill. I was very responsible for the historical accuracy of the product. So Levi?
Yeah, when Mark came to me and said we were going to do the project, I had to do a lot of reading, a lot of research, kind of to find out where to go with it, with the help of Justin and the information I was allowed to have here, I came up with this. We did a blend of wheat and corn, which are two ingredients that are used in brewing, but rarely like this. This is an unfiltered wheat beer, and its base is wheat, it's wheat, and that's unusual. Most places use barley. Barley's a little easier to deal with, but we wanted to make this. And when we're talking about hops, it's one of those things we really don't know. There were hops grown here. You know, who knows what they were. The hop we used is a modern blend of a wild American hop and the very popular at the time English Golden. So that would have been a hop that was very popular in America in pale ales, porters, and whatnot. So that was how we could get as historically accurate as we could get with modern. So understanding that, that's where it came from.
Just one quick word about recipe or lack thereof. So we're saying this is historically inspired. There is, on record, no specific recipe for what was brewed here. And it was Levi's research. He very diligently read through the 1804 brewing manual by Michael Combroom called Theory and Practice of Brewing. It's a title that Jefferson owned. It's what, when people ask Jefferson, you know, what was his recipe for his beer, he said, well, there isn't one, but if I were to refer you to the best single source on how to sort of perform this operation, it would be Combroom. So, you know, we're very pleased that that Levi took the initiative to read that treatise and really kind of learn the process of what was just standard practice at the time. So that's where this recipe is coming from.
Ready?
Shall we?
So it's we're gonna do a commemorative toast in honor of Thomas Jefferson and get a picture here if you guys want to see the picture. Okay, so what we're going to do is, because there's a big, not mob, well, anyhow, we're going to split it into two sides.